Very good morning, one and all. Most respected principal of Kumbakonam Arts and Science College for Women, Autonomous, and respected Department of HOD and Organization Secretary, my dear friend Dr. Ravi, Associate Professor, and my dear participant. And thank you very much for inviting me for this wonderful occasion. And before that, I would like to thank to our authorities of Annamalai and University for permitting me for this wonderful day. I am very fortunate with the help of our senior having this wonderful meeting should be arranged in good manner for forenoon session. So you would have very good interactions with the participant. So that way we are very happy. For especially I am thankful to organizing committee members, for especially the organizing secretary, Dr. Ravi. Within the short period, I am going to share my research area and my own research field, fish immunology. My dear friends, you know very well about that immune system and immune responses of fishes. You know pretty well, it is very old animal group, fishes. So that way you know the different type of system is there. That means reproductive system, circulatory system, and immune system also is one of the system. You know, system means it's a compartment. Each compartment having individual work. So that means the fish immune system is one of the compartment. It is having own function and responsibility. So that way, today I am going to talk about fish immune system and immune responses. What is mean by fish immune system? So you know very well about that, where it is originated, when it is originated. So you can wait and see one by one. I will definitely share with you, my dear friends. So these are the content I am going to present my ideas and work plan. So that means, what is the immune system? That means defense system, innate immune responses, and acute immune responses, and what are the immune organs? You know pretty well. So that way, within the short time, I am going to present one by one. My dear friends, the fishes classified in three categories. You know very well about that. Jawless fishes, very good example for Agneta, and cartilaginous fishes, very good example for shark and rays. And bony fishes, the scientific name mastichthyes, and example for trout, carp, and tilapia in marine water, mackerel, etc., etc. So these are the fishes. You know very well about that. All the system is very well developed. What about the immune system? In case of jawless fishes, in case of cartilage fishes, in case of bony fishes, any differences is there or not? Any response, maybe the immune response may be differ or not. You are going to see one by one, my dear friends. Basically, structurally, some small differences is there in mammals and fish immune system. But functionally, there is no any difference. First, you keep it in your mind. So in case of fishes, there is no any difference functional wise in higher animals, that means higher vertebrate animals. So that way, the immune system is the science. that studies the structure and the functioning of the immune system. How we are going to define this, the immunology means we are going to study about the structure and the functioning of the immune system. So this is the scientific definition, and now you are going to recognize that any system, first you should be recognize and the response. So that way the immune system is a two activities is very important. One should recognize the component and next immediately respond it. So that way, first whenever enter the foreign substances in the system, immediately the organ should be recognized it is a harmful one or helpful one. So that system immediately going to respond it. So this the two activity is a very important one. How do you are going to develop the immunity in case of the fishes? So recognition and the response is there very, very important for the immunity development. So that way the defense system is basically divided in two categories. Already you know very well about that. The innate immune responses are defense system and acute or adaptive defense system. My dear friends, the inborn defense system already the naturally immune system. Every organism they have own response naturally. You cannot going to create anything. You cannot give anything. It's naturally it is present. At the time of fertilization, the egg development stage, in embryology conditions, in embryo conditions, you have natural immunity. After that, that yolk sac undergo going to develop to form hemophytic stem cells. After that, the hemophytic stem cells give rise to form so many cells proliferations. That means lymphoid progenitors, myeloid progenitors, and platelets, and etc. These are the cells that are going to involved in different functions in different way. So that way, the natural immune system means it is an inborn defense system, naturally present there. Every organism having the capacity to innate immune responses. In case of fishes, what are the components? What are the important things? What are the important area is there? Maybe the any physical, any chemical, or any biological aspect is there. We are going to see, my dear friends, one by one. So that way, the innate immune system means it is an epithelial surface. It is a physical and a chemical barrier against invading microorganism. So this is the first line of defense mechanism in fishes. The epithelial surfaces, the epithelial cells, it is involved in, that means external innate defense mechanism. Our next component, lectins or natural agglutinin. The natural agglutinin in fish can be detected as natural precipitant. Maybe very good example for many catfishes, they have secreted so many lectins. So that lectins is an antimicrobial peptide is there, immediately kill the microbes. So that way, the lectin also it is a key role for innate immune responses. In case of the teleost fish, C-reactive protein, that means CRP, is a serum component. So this serum component react with the polysaccharide structure at the cell surface of microorganism. So this CRP protein is a key role for killing the microorganism. It is a naturally present the fish system. So this is a very good example for innate immune or inborn defense mechanism in fishes. A next component, lysosome, you know pretty well. This lysosome is found in fish mucus, serum, and eggs. It is able to digest the peptidoglycan layer of bacterial cell walls. So this is the another very, very good example for innate immune mechanism. And next, interferon. The interferon is a cytokine that is produced by many cell types in response to viral infection. My dear friends, you know very well about that. The interferon protein is a main role, key role for it kill the viral particles. With the help of the T cells, the interferon going to react should be identify the viral infection. In case of fishes, it is very sensitive one. The interferon is a major role for its innate mechanism functions. And complement system, next the innate immune mechanisms, next part, next component, is consists of a group of proteins and non-protein component that are involved in both innate mechanism and a specific adaptive immunity. What is mean by complement system? My dear friends, you know very well about that. Some proteins naturally inactive in nature, some group of proteins. In case of human being also, in the skin region, in circulatory region, in between the tissues, some useless protein. What is the name of that? Useless protein. Protein is there. When they are going to involve in the some metabolic and immune function, once you are going to stimulate or you are going to activate, then only that group of proteins going to react. So that way, this complement protein is an inactive protein. It's a non-protein component. You are going to give some external force, or naturally you give some temperature. Immediately, the fish is going to react immediately, move immediately. So that type of the protein is complement protein. You know pretty well. This complement protein is other name known as C proteins. Rupturing the cell membrane of the microbes. It is very, very important, my dear friends. You know very well about that. It is stimulates, the complement protein stimulates mast cells to produce histamines. So whenever you get the blood clotting, it's immediately the histamines is a key role for the arrest the blood flowing areas. This the mast cell is a key role for going to stimulate. This complement protein, not only for the innate defense mechanism, it is also involved in the adaptive immune mechanism in case of fishes. And inflammatory reaction, this complement protein is a key role for strengthening the inflammatory reactions. Not only that, it is act as hemokines. It's a proteins, the hemokine proteins, when you're going to act, this complement protein is a involved in releasing some hemokines like proteins. So that proteins involved in lysis or opsonization function and attract the phagocytes to the infected area. So that name, the phagocytosis, is only they are going to activate means. So this type of the proteins, this type of the non-protein component, they're going to create, induce and attack the enemies and immediately engulf the pathogens and wherever in the infected area and they kill them and lysis them. So that way the complement protein is a key role for adaptive and as well as innate immune mechanism. And inflammation. So the inflammation is a local reactions upon tissue damage. Already I mentioned that is caused by invading microorganism. For the example, the soluble protein, soluble factors, but the clotting system, canine system, the complement system, and the cells, you know very well about that, the thrombocytes, granulocytes, and macrophages. So these are the cells key role for inflammation reaction. It's play a role in innate immune responses. So you know the very well, already I told them, very well developed innate immune mechanism in fishes, you compare to adaptive responses. What is the reason of that? It is a primitive vertebrate animal. You cannot have a good, all the system cannot develop very well, or especially in fish immune system is there, very well developed. But you compare to adaptive immune responses, its innate immune responses is a well-known and very well developed compared to the adaptive immune responses. So that way, the inflammatory reactions is a key role for innate immune mechanism functions. Next, the phagocytic cells, the macrophages and the neutrophilic granulocytes in fish are the principle of phagocytic cells. My dear friends, you know very well about that. Which cells is going to modify to kill the pathogens? So that way, this particular neutrophil cells, the macrophage cells, going to modify and act as a phagocytic cells. So immediately kill the pathogens whenever entering the system, whenever entering the surface area of the skin. So that way, the phagocytic cells is a key role for innate immune mechanisms. So these cells recognize evolutionary converted epitopes present on the microorganism using so-called pattern recognition receptor. That means PRRS, pattern recognizing receptor. The phagocytic cells are the macrophagic cells also a PRRS cells. If the neutrophilic granulocytes also is a PRRS cells. So these cells is a key role for innate immune mechanisms. A non-specific cytotoxic cell, these cells are the teliastri equivalent on mammalian natural killer cells. My dear friend, the NK cell, natural killer cells, one of the, it is a immune cell. This cells, in case of in teliastri cells, the other name known as is called a non-specific cytotoxic cells. It's probably it is involved in killing protozoan parasites and virus infected cells. So these are the main area. Already I told them cytotoxic cells is a key role for killing the virus cells, kill the virus infected cells. So that mean it is called, the other name is called a NK cell. The mammalian cells is called a NK cells. This cells is equivalent to non-specific cytotoxic cells. So this is one of the very, very important cell that is involved in the inborn immune system. So you know that these are the innate immune mechanisms of in the fishes. And next category, you are going to see the acute immunity, a complex network of specialized cells. So proteins, genes, and biochemical messages. So these are the cell is a key role for acute immunity. Innate immunity, so many components involved in the defense mechanism. In acute, in adaptive immunity means it is a complex network of the system. It is not a single cell is going to react it and lyses the pathogens or entering the pathogens. It is a group of or network of the cells involved in adaptive immune responses. So that way, the proteins, genes, and biochemical messages, these are the cells is a very important for acute immunity to respond specifically to the antigens, antibody, and the effector cells with high specificity and affinity. My dear friends, you know very well about that antigens. Two type of antigen is there. What is the two type of complete antigen and incomplete antigen? So the only the immunogens like antigens we are going to respond. It specifically it is involved in acute immunity responses and antibodies. Type of antibodies, you know, different type of antibody is there. Next slide, you are going to see the what is the antibody and effector cells, regulator cells. The T cells also is a key role for specific immune responses. You should remember that. Next, the antibodies. So many antibodies there. What is the type of the antibody? Only the five types. You know pretty well about that. IgM, IgG, IgE, and IgD, and IgA. But in case of fishes, it's very limited. IgM is a one of the antibodies, and some fishes, IgD also is there, having some important role for antibody productions. So in Jones 1999 reported that the IgM specific antibody can be generated in the skin, intestine, gills, without necessary generating a systemic responses. You should remember, my dear friends, the skin and the intestine, gills also they secrete the antibodies. You know, in the immune organs, later slide you are going to see that, the immune organs in head kidney is a main source for including the number of antibodies. But in addition to that, so these are the organ already reported in 99, Jones et al. The skin also is a produce some antibody. Not only for the skin, intestine parts, abdominal intestine also is having for producing some antibody. In telias, is a tetramer in nature. The immunoglobulin M class, it's a tetramer in nature and contain 8 antigenic combining sites. You should remember the structure of the antibodies. So the IgM is a one of the best antibody to involved in acute immunity responses. You should remember that. Immunological memories. Next, adaptive immunity and adaptive immune system. The B cells is a important role for memory cells. You should remember, you whenever they entering the same antigen, immediately your system going to recognize, oh, this is a useful antigen, useful partner. So we cannot create any disturb in this our bodies. Immediately our system is recognized. The fish body is recognized there. So that way the B cells is a very important role for immunological memories. They give rise to have the memory power. The fish had developed a memory response before a second exposure to an antigen. My dear friends, first you inject the antigens, and second, even once again you are going to inject the antigen, immediately fish going to develop the memory response. Already they reported Arcus and Kotari in 1991, the Whittington in et al. 1994, in case of rainbow trout respond to suboptimal doses of both T lymphocytes in an antigenic dependent and antigenic independent manner after an initial exposure to the same antigen. My dear friends, you should remember, so the response to suboptimal level of antigen suggested that perhaps B cells with high affinity receptor were selected as memory B cells. It is involved in adaptive immune responses. Next, the cellular cytotoxicity. In leukocytes, it is involved in cytotoxicity reactions, in capable on generating for the cellular reactions. The sequence of the fish homologous of MHC3 and T cell suggests that CD8 MHC class 1. My dear friends, you know very well about the T cells give rise to form two type of cell, CD4 and CD8 in higher cases. In case of fishes, the CD3 also is having important role for cytotoxicity aspect. And CD8 MHC class 1 molecule, it is reference state is similar to that of which occurs in higher vertebrates. In CBAS, the telast cell appear early in larval development, at least 5 days after the start of incubation. You should remember this, my dear friends. The cellular cytotoxicity, the T cell is a key role. Then only the entering viral particle, immediately that viral particle going to kill because of the help of the T cells. Then only it is possible. If the absence of the T cell or failing of the T cell, immediately the viral particle damage the system due to you are going to the fish and sample or the fish animal immediately going to die. So that way the cellular cytotoxicity is a key role for adaptive immune responses. And next, the cytokines involved in adaptive immunities. The cytokines have been described in adaptive immunity in fishes. In recent discovery, the CD4, already told him, the CD4, one of the T lymphocyte give rise to form CD4. In teleas, it is seem likely these cytokines will drive the activation and the differentiation of the T helper cell subset. You know the two type of T cells. What is that? T helper cell and T cytotoxic cell and T suppressor cells. So these cells is a release different cytokines. So immediately we are going to identify the which one is the harmful person, harmful virus. Immediately we are going to kill the pathogens. So that way the cytokines is a major role for adaptive immunity. My dear friends, So these are the two responses, innate immune responses and acute responses. So many components they are involved in immune response activity. Next, you are going to see the immune organs. What is the immune organs? You know pretty well, the thymus, it is present in the operculare cavity, superficial region of the operculare cavity. The thymus is a primary lymphoid organ. It's a pair of lymphoid organ. It is an opaque in color. My dear friends, whenever your practical class, go and dissect it and see the location of the thymus and the coloration of the thymus, you are able to try to identify that. And another important organ, immune organ, spleen. It is located in the abdominal cavity near small intestine. It is boat-like structure in red in color. It is important role for blood filtering functions. The thymus is an important role for cell-mediated immune response. You remove the thymus, what is the name of that? Thymectomy, immediately the cell-mediated immune response is going to arrest. And next, the immune organ is kidney. It is near to vertebral column. It is two types of kidneys there, anterior kidney and posterior kidney. You know very well about that. Anterior kidney is other name known as head kidney. And posterior kidney is other name known as trunk kidney. The kidney is a two in role. One is producing the antibody and another, the trunk kidney, it is involved in filtration of the waste components, waste particles. So the head kidney is a important for producing the antibodies. My dear friend, you should remember, head kidney is a one of the major immune organ in fishes. In addition to that, gut is also is a part of immune organ. It is alimentary canal, it's a body cavity. You can go and inject the in fish sample, you can able to see the in gut. It's part of the gut is also release the lymphocytes. That lymphocytes kill the microbes. So that way, gut also it's one of the immune organ. And not last but not least, the mucus. Mucus secreting lymphoid associated tissues, malt. The malt also is a one of the lymphoid tissues. So these are the immune organs in fishes. Within the short time, my dear friends, the time is, I think, going to end. I'm going to finish my talk. So that way, so if you have any queries, please come forward. I will try to clear your queries. Each one, please will try to give your feedback. Try to, you can ask me whenever, wherever. If you have any doubt, please call me or mail me immediately. I will reply to you. Immediately, I will try to give your questions. Are the answers. Okay. So next, you are going to see the references. What are the references? If you whenever free ever go and refer this book. It's a very good book for fish immunology, for especially in fish immunology. So you go through this LS 1999 and past year 1992 is a very good book for antibody diversity in especially for the lower vertebrates. The in fish immune system in cell biology and immunology group already published in Netherlands. So you can going to have any in small diagram and other thing, you can go and see the website, Google website, to be able to identify that. So my dear friends, that so if you have, I would like thank to the organizing secretaries, Dr. Ravi sir and HOD madam. I am very thankful to madam for even having wonderful session. I am really thankful to one and all for this wonderful session and all the faculty members of Department of Zoology in the Government Arts and College, Kumbakonam. Thank you very much, one and all. We will see you. Thank you.